Do not skip this vid. Watch it all the way through, or you're going to miss important details. You're going to be looking goofy. I would not risk it. What's good, YouTube, man? It's your boy, Based Out Brad. Had to spin the block on y'all with another banger today, man. And today, I am back with another banger upload vid for y'all boys, man. You see the title. I'm bringing y'all boys the best two-way playmaker build on NBA 2K22, man. Let me tell y'all, if you guys need a build to rep grind on, want a build that can literally do everything in the game, I mean, be a pest from shooting, defense, playmaking, the build can really do it all. It's really a three-way playmaker, bro. You need a build that you're just trying to hop on. You can play with anybody at any point in time. This is the build right here. This build is OP. It's ridiculous. And I'm going to show y'all boys how to make this build. So let's go ahead and get into this thing. Now, first things first, we're going to go to our features. And we're going to go to our settings. Now, we're going to make this build with the metric system. So we're going to go to our units of measurement and change the imperial system to the metric system. And I'm going to tell y'all boys why later on in this vid. But make sure y'all boys do that first. All right. So first things first, we're actually going to make this build a shooting guard. Your hand, I always go with left-handed builds, so that's just my personal preference, but feel free to go whatever hand that you like, and the jersey number does not matter. All right, so your pod chart, we're actually going to use the one that has the most playmaking and the most defense, so Hall of Fame playmaking and defense. On your physical profile, I know most guard builds, of course you want to go with the pod chart that gives you the most speed, but we're actually going to choose the pod chart that gives you the most vert and a decent amount of speed, because we're still going to get a 99 speed and 99 acceleration with this build and a 90 plus vert in the end. So we're actually going to choose the pod chart that gives you the most speed and the most vert, which is this one right here. All right, now for your finishing, you're going to put your close shot at an 84, your driving layup to an 84, put that driving dunk up to a 78, and then your standing dunk, you're going to put that up to a 32. It's going to give you 7 finishing badges. All right, so you're shooting, we're going to max out your mid-range, max out your three-point shot, max out your free throw, and put your post fade up to a 59. That's going to give you right at 10 shooting badges. Now, you're going to be decent with shooting. 10 badges is just enough for a two-way playmaker. Remember, this build isn't primarily focused on shooting, but you will be able to shoot, and 10 badges is just enough to be able to shoot consistent behind the arc, bro. Playmaking now, max out your pass accuracy, max out your ball handle, and you're going to leave the post control, giving you 20 points for your Hall of Fame category of playmaking. Leave the interior, max out your perimeter, max out your lateral, max out your steal, put your block up to a 47, and then we're going to max out our defensive rebound. It's going to give you 19 defensive badges. So you got Hall of Fame playmaking and defense, you get 20 playmaking, 19 defense, 10 shooting badges, and 7 finishing badges, man. This is an all-around build, you know what I'm saying? You can actually put on the badges that you need to be effective and be consistent, most importantly. So now with the height, we're going to go with the 1.95 meters. Now revert back to why I told you guys to change your build system to the metric system. There's a small glitch in 2K. Now at 1.95, we're going to be listed at 6'5", but we're still going to be able to get those 6'4 animations. Even though we technically 6'5", with this little bug, we technically 6'4". So we're going to get all the dribble moves, all the season dribble moves, everything. You're going to on your weight. We're going to drop that thing down to 81 kg, give you a 92 speed, a 91 acceleration, and an 88 vertical. Now, let's do the math. Now, you add in plus 4 after 99, your plus 4 with your gym rat, that's 8. You know what I'm saying? So add that to that 92 speed. You're going to have a 99 speed with this build. Same thing with your acceleration. You're going to have a 99 acceleration with this build. Add it up with your vertical too. You're going to have a 96 vertical on this build, bro. 96 vertical. So a 99 speed, 99 acceleration, a 96 vertical. You finna be unstoppable, bro. You are about to be literally unstoppable. Hall of Fame defense, Hall of Fame playmaking. You can shoot. You got badges to dunk. I'm telling you, bro, this is the perfect rebirth build. If you want to make a new build, the perfect rep grinding build. Like, it's the one, bro. It's the one. Now, your wingspan, you're going to max that thing all the way out. Max it all the way out on your wingspan. Now, your three-point shot does, you know what I'm saying, takes a little hit. But, you know what I'm saying, it's people out here shooting with 60-60 tray balls consistent with set shots. You feel me, bro? You can shoot with this build when you get takeover. You know what I'm saying? That's plus 10. So, you're going to be turned up. You're going to be turned up, bro.
And it's ridiculous, man. You're going to get that 85 ball handle at 96, you feel me? But until then, you still get pro dribbles at like 75 or something like that, bro. So you're going to be good. You get the pro handles off the rim, matter of fact. So you're gonna be straight, bro. This build is going to be a problem. It's going to be a problem, bro. Now, I always say you have a unique build if you get four different takeovers. And you got some decisions to make right here, bro. You want to have fun? You can go playmaking, have fun, catch ankles, whatever the case may be. That's cool. Your lockdown take, it takes a little longer to get the lockdown take, but if you really out there flying around, playing the passing lanes, I done seen some toxic shit with this build, bro. Not even gonna hold you, bro. Like, literally, like, every time somebody passed the ball, they taking it every time. Like, 99 speed, 99 acceleration, don't forget. Now, you can really get toxic with this lockdown badge, but I feel like the slashing badge would be the best badge to put on this build, the most fun badge in my opinion, but do feel free to go with either one of these two. We're going with slashing for my build. And as you guys can see, you're going to get that two-way playmaker, really a three-way playmaker, man. This build is ridiculous. This build is goated. If you're about to make a rebirth build, bro, definitely get your money's worth. Make something where you can play with anybody at any point in time. You can play 1 through 3, 1 through 5, damn near. Like, if you guys enjoyed today's video and want to see more, man, don't forget to like, subscribe, turn those post notifications on. Leave a comment down below. Let me know if this build is a W or an L. I feel like it's a W. Definitely a good rep grinding build, man. You can definitely go crazy with it. With the rebirth, man, you get the badges off the rip, half the badges, so it won't take you that long to max out. Big shout out to the base game once again for you guys' love and support, man. Can't thank you guys enough. Shout out to the NBU boys as well. Make sure if y'all new to the channel, man, hit that sub, smash that like, pop out to the Twitch streams, man. We going crazy over there as well, bro. If you want to see me live in action on these builds, any of these builds I posted as of late, you want to see me go crazy, want to have a good time, good vibes, follow that Twitch link down below in the description and come pop out, show your boy some love. So again, this has been your boy, Based Out Brad, and as always, Based Out.